Hey, you action figure enthusiasts out there, JC here with another T&I toy review. And today's review is in association with MarvelousNews.com, your number one news source for everything Marvel. And for today's review, I'm going to be taking a look at the brand new Marvel Studios, the first 10 years Marvel Legends Ant-Man movie, Ant-Man and Yellow Jacket figure 2-pack from Hasbro. Now this figure is part of the new subline of Marvel Legends celebrating 10 years of Marvel movies. It comes packaged in the same style we've been seeing with all the Marvel Studio figures. You've got the black box with the red highlights. Up at the top, you've got the Marvel Studios logo and the Legends series logo. The figures are clearly displayed in the window box. Down below, you've got the characters' names, and then you've got that symbol for Ant-Man, and you also have the Ant-Man title from the first Ant-Man movie, which is what these figures are based on. On the side of the packaging, on one side, you've got some artwork from the first Ant-Man movie, and when you put all these MCU figure packages together, they'll form a collage image, which is kind of cool. And then on the other side, you've got a bio for the Ant-Man movie that was released in 2015. Also, it tells us this is set number 8 in this series. And then on the back of the packaging, you've got a look at the first Ant-Man movie poster. And then you've got bios for both Ant-Man and Yellow Jacket. All right, let's get this open and take a look at what's inside. Okay, so here's a look at the figures outside the packaging along with the other content. Okay, now first of all, you get these little teeny miniature versions of Yellow Jacket and Ant-Man, and basically these are made so you can kind of pretend like they've shrunk down to microscopic size, but they're not very detailed. There's no articulation to them. They don't even really stand on their own power. So with the Yellow Jacket one, it's done with just a black plastic, and you can make out some yellow on his chest and his stomach and on his eyes. And then he's got these arms that stick out, which are done with kind of a flexible type plastic. And then with the Ant-Man figure, again, very tiny, no articulation. He's got the red with the metallic silver on his helmet and on his belt. But because they don't really stand on their own, you know, you have to kind of prop them up against something, and there's just really not a whole lot you can do with these. Now, Ant-Man also comes with a second head sculpt. It's an unmasked head sculpt that's made to look like Paul Rudd. Now, we saw something very similar with the Ant-Man and the Wasp version that was released on single card in the regular Marvel Legend line. Really, the only difference is they didn't include that smirk with this one, which I know a lot of people didn't like about that previous one. Now, I think this one that came with the regular Marvel Legend figure actually looks a little more like Paul Rudd than this one that came with this 2-pack. It's still, you can tell it's made to look like Rudd. I think it's more of the paint applications are a little bit off. I don't know. I see more Paul Rudd in that previous one, even though it's got that goofy smirk. Maybe it's because it's got the goofy smirk. I don't know. But if you want an unmasked Paul Rudd head, you know, I think this does a pretty good job. And again, if you didn't like that smirk with the previous one, then you'll probably like this one better. Okay, and switching out the heads is easy. You just pop off the head you want to replace. It's got a ball hinge joint there, and then you just pop on the head you want to replace it with, and it should pop on and fit nice and tight. Now, one thing I do want to note, that this non-smirking head sculpt is actually not compatible with the Ant-Man and the Wasp version. If you have that figure, and we're hoping you could take that unmasked head from this new figure and put it on that other figure, the ball on this Ant-Man and the Wasp version is bigger than the one in this box set, so that non-smirking head is not going to actually fit on there, unfortunately. Okay, now Yellow Jacket for accessories comes with this backpack piece that has his arms attached to it. Now, this is actually something that is on the figure when you take it out of the packaging, but you can remove it. So with this, you've got these smaller arms at the top, and basically all you can do with those is you can do them up and down. You can also rotate them. So now when it's on the figure, you can't really rotate it forward. You can only do it backwards, but you do have rotation with these smaller arms at the top. And then with the larger arms on the bottom, you do have an articulated joint where it connects to the backpack piece, so you can rotate there, and you've got up and down movement there. And then you've got a hinge joint here, so you can do the leg up and down there, and there's no rotation there. You do have a rotating joint here, though, midway between on the leg, So you can rotate it, and then again you have up and down movement. And then for the rest of the leg, it looks like there might be articulated joints here, but they're not. So there's no articulation on this bottom portion of the larger leg. Now it is done with a softer plastic, so you can kind of move it around a little bit, but there's not an actual articulated joint. So basically you've got articulation here, here, and here. And then with these upper ones, you just have the articulation where it attaches to the backpack. Put it on the figure, you've got the hole in the back and you got the little peg on the backpack, and you just plug it in and it does fit nice and tight. Okay, now for the figures themselves, starting with Ant-Man. So this figure seems to be essentially a reuse of the previous first Ant-Man movie figure that we got from Hasbro. We do have a new head sculpt with it, a more accurate looking helmet, which I think is good. I do like this helmet. You've got the metallic silver, you've got the red on the eyes, and then you've got the red striping there on the top of the head and on the side. It does have the breathing apparatus, so it covers up his face and everything. And then you've got this piece that's on the back here, which is actually attached to the figure, but you know, it looks like it's part of the helmet and everything. So overall, you know, I think this is a much better looking and more movie accurate helmet than what we got on the previous Ant-Man figure from the first movie. Now for the rest of the figure, the overall figure itself seems to be the same. There are some minor differences, some added sculpting detail. Primarily, you've got these ridges that are actually sculpted on the red portions here on the chest, which is nice, and here again on the back and down here on his butt and everything. On that original figure, this was all smooth, so you didn't have that sculpting detail. So I again like that. But otherwise, you know, it seems to be pretty much the same with some varying paint differences, but the overall sculpting of the suit seems to be pretty much the same. Same belt. Now with this new figure, the belt is much more cleaner looking. It's done with the metallic silver with the red markings, but there's no black wash effect like on the previous one. And then you've got the silver markings throughout, which are sculpted on there. Same with the previous figure, you've got the sculpting detail on his underside here at the midsection, and that's the same as the previous figure. And then you've got the red on the bottom of the legs here, and you've got some sculpting detail on the boots and some line work sculpted on the knee pads. So all of that's the same between the two figures. Actually, you didn't have the red markings on the lower legs like you did on this new one. So like I said, the figure overall is the same, but you've got a different head sculpt, which is more movie accurate, and you've got a little more detailing on the figure itself, which again makes it more movie accurate. Now, one thing I do want to note on the Ant-Man figure, the red on the shoulders here seems to be a little bit brighter shade than the red here on the chest. Here in the midsection, it's also a little bit different shade than here on the chest. Here in the midsection, it's not as noticeable, but on the shoulders here, it is definitely a little bit brighter and stands out when you've got it in the light. On the back here, the shades of red here and here are about the same, but again, are darker than here on the shoulder pads. Okay, now for the Yellow Jacket figure, this is a new figure. We've never gotten an MCU version of the Yellow Jacket before. Now most of this figure is done with just a black plastic. There's not a whole lot of paint detail. You've got the yellow portions throughout the figure, which I actually think look good on the black. And then I like the sculpting detail through most of the yellow with those ridges and everything. Some areas like here under his neck and then here on his rib cage is done with a metallic yellow. There's no ridges or anything sculpted, but I think that looks good. I like the way the metallic yellow picks up the light. On his helmet, he's got this translucent yellow plastic that covers the eyes. And then you've got a light color underneath there. I don't know if that's yellow. It looks yellow because the translucent plastic I'm looking through is yellow. So it gives you that kind of yellow tint to it, which is nice. And then the rest of the helmet is just done black, and you've got some sculpting detail. And then on the back of the figure, you've got the hole where the backpack matches up or plugs in. And I think the yellow on the backpack piece actually matches up with the rest of the figure nicely. Now the one area where I've got a little bit of off yellow is here on the elbows with these elbow joints. This yellow here and here is a little bit different shade than the rest of the figure. So I'm not sure why that is. Not a big deal. You know, it's very small and on the back, but you know, when you are looking at it, it does stand out a little bit. And then the rest of the figure, like down the legs, you've got some nice sculpting detail and everything. But overall, I think they've done a pretty good job of capturing the likeness of Yellow Jacket from the movie. Okay, now Yellow Jacket is the taller of the two figures. He stands right about 6 3/4 inches tall. And then Ant-Man comes in just a little bit under 6.5 inches tall. Okay, now for a comparison, here's a look at the older Ant-Man movie figure that Hasbro did with the newer one. And even though these two primarily use the same body, because you get the new head sculpt and you have the added detail on this new figure. I think it is a much more improved and movie accurate looking figure. And then finally, here's a comparison of the Wasp figure. And again, these two are about the same height.
So for articulation, starting with Ant-Man, you can turn his head to the left and to the right, and he can look down pretty good. And then he can look up about that much. You don't really get any head pivot with this one. Arms attached with your standard ball hinge joint there at the shoulders, and get his arm out good. Has good rotation at the shoulder. Has a bicep swivel. Has a double hinged elbow, so good bending there at the elbow. Has rotation at the wrist and hinges on the hand, so up and down movement there. You've got a midsection joint, so he can crunch forward about that much. And then he can look back about that much. You've got a waist swivel with this one. With the legs, he can do the splits about that much. You can get the leg forward good. And then you can only do the leg back about that much. He does have a thigh swivel, has a double jointed knee, so good bending there at the knee. And then with the feet, you have hinges, so up and down movement. And then you do have ankle pivot. And two peg holes on the bottom.
With yellow jacket, he can turn his head to the left and to the right, and he can look down a little bit, and he can look up about that much. With him, you also don't get much in the way of head pivot. He can get his arm out good, has good rotation there at the shoulder, has a bicep swivel, has a double hinged elbow, so he can bend his elbow that much. He has rotation at the hands, has the hinges there, so he's got the up and down movement there with the hands, has a midsection joint, so he can only crunch forward about that much. And then he can look back a little bit as well. You get a waist swivel with him. With him, he can do the splits that much, and he can get his leg forward good. And he can do his leg out and back. He's got a thigh swivel. He's got a double jointed knee, so good bending there at the knee. And then with the feet, you've got hinges, so up and down movement. And he does have ankle pivot as well. And two peg holes on the bottom of the feet.
Okay, so that's my review. So overall, I would say this is a pretty solid set. With the Ant-Man figure, it is primarily a reuse of the previous one that they did. However, the new head sculpt is much more movie accurate with the helmet, and the added detail to the figure makes it for an overall improvement and worth getting in its own right. You also get the unmasked head, which looks pretty decent. It is not compatible with the Ant-Man and the Wasp version though, so just be wary of that. For the Yellow Jacket figure, I think it's a solid representation of the character. It is the first time that we've gotten Yellow Jacket, which is cool in its own right. I like the way the arms work, and I like how the yellow looks on the black. So if you're a fan of these characters or the first Ant-Man movie, I think this is a set you're definitely going to want to check out, even if you have the previous Ant-Man figure. Now this set, along with the rest of the MCU figures, should start hitting shelves at the end of this month or early next month. However, this is actually currently available on the Hasbro Toy Shop website, at least as I was filming this. So if you want to try and pick it up there, you can do so now. We'll have a full image gallery up at MarvelousNews.com. There'll be a link in the video description below. As always, leave a comment. Let me know what you think. If you're so inclined, please like the video. And if you haven't already, please subscribe to the channel by hitting that button down below. I'd really appreciate it. You should also hit that bell notification so you're alerted every time I upload a new video. And of course, you can also follow me on my Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and Twitch accounts. I have links to all those in the video description as well. And until next time, guys, I'll catch you later.